What's up, guys? Pastor Rob here, back with another reaction video. As usual, I'm joined by my son, Gage.
What's up?
And as usual, we're going to listen to a song requested by you guys. Mm-hmm. Actually, we're going to listen to a brand new release song and analyze it from a biblical perspective. Yep. I guess I did get one request, so we can go with that. Mm-hmm. Now, keep in mind, we're examining this song as an individual piece, unless otherwise specified. So this is not an endorsement of the song, the artist, or the genre as a whole, but an attempt to create discussion and encourage discernment while listening to music. Mm-hmm. For additional resources related to the channel, including additional commentary and merch, or to learn more about us and our mission, visit PastorRobReacts.com. Oh, and don't forget to follow us on social media. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. We post mm-hmm. almost daily. We have some bonus content and some educational content there, so make sure you follow us. Links to all of this and to additional study-related material in the description of this video. So today's reaction is a special one. It's a new release from a band that we're familiar with called August Burns Red.
Yep, my first metal show.
Yeah, first metal show that you went to. That's your first metal show, period.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's
first
right. Yeah, show. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We did a reaction to that to them, I don't know, months ago, where I told him that we got VIP passes and all that.
Yeah.
So we got to meet the band mm-hmm. and hang out with everybody. Pretty cool. It's the Constellations Tour.
Yeah.
It's where we discovered, well, where I discovered.
Silent Planet.
Silent Planet. I think I'm a shirt mm-hmm. representing. I figured yep. it'd be a good one to wear in this video.
Yeah, and also Silverstein. They opened up for August Burns Red.
Which is right. It's his favorite band. One of his
favorites. One of my favorites. I wasn't familiar with them up until seeing them at the concert.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So that was a very pleasant surprise.
Oh, cool.
That's how I got into them.
Cool, yeah, good. Well, that's excellent. Well, they just released a new song called Defender from their album Guardians, which will be available April 3rd, 2020. It's from Fearless Records. And from what I understand, it's written by Matt Greiner and JB Brubaker. I don't know how to say his name. Sorry mm-hmm. if I mispronounce your name there, JB. We met all you guys at the show. You were so great. Matt was yep. really awesome. Mm-hmm. Matt's a professing Christian. So I don't know. I'm just excited. I saw some clips on Instagram about, is there a gnat?
I see it too.
I saw some clips on Instagram mm-hmm. of the art for the video, and I texted Gage today. I said, Gage, as soon as I get home, we're doing a video, mm-hmm. which is rare because typically we just do them on the weekend or something.
Yeah, usually there's a lot of like
prep.
Yeah,
yeah, getting mm-hmm. all the cameras ready. We'll do a couple songs at a time. So
yeah,
it was a little bit
this
leading
one was
up
kind
to
of spontaneous.
It. Yeah, this was spontaneous. So we're really, really excited to get into it. So let's just dive in. Quit wasting time. Yeah. Here we go. Already sick, man. Goodness.
Yeah.
Man, that's more wiles than our Judith video, I think.
Someone's got to count and figure out which one had the most.
Don't do it. Don't. Y'all leave me alone. No.
I think you beat Owen Wilson.
Not the Owen Wilson joke again. You can't use that more than once on the channel.
I'm sorry.
What'd you think?
I think it was great. Excellent vocals, guitars, drums. Everything was solid. Bass. It was sick.
I am going to stretch here and say it slapped. Hey, yeah, you can't leave the show. You can't leave the show.
Have you been watching Davey 504?
I don't even know what that is. I see it in the comments sometimes, and I've adapted it. It could be bad. I don't even know. If it's a good thing, then it slapped. Is that twice too many times? Anyway, I enjoyed the song very much. That breakdown was sick.
Mm-hmm.
The video, the visuals. I got to admit, as far as creativity goes, I believe August Burns Red is probably one of the best in the industry.
Yeah, I like how they're willing to have fun, like a comic book music video. They're not pretentious.
Not pretentious at all, which I love about them. If you follow them on social media,
yeah, they seem like fun guys.
Just fun guys. I mean, Jake, the singer, just constantly showing us his dog and playing airsoft, fake army stuff. You know, I'm not mocking you, Jake. You're a lot bigger than me, but that's what he's doing, right? And then you got Matt. Matt's always doing something really cool, helping somebody out. He has his, I think it's Holy Ghost Notes podcast that he does.
Mm-hmm.
He's doing some. A benefit for cancer, related to cancer.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, he does some drum teaching. Mm-hmm. He's a farmer.
Oh, really?
Yeah. JB's always doing something crazy. I don't follow everybody else, so I'm sorry. I bet they're just the same. But
yeah.
JB just renovated his office or something, he's walked us along with that. They just seem like fun dudes.
Yeah.
Great show. The show was fantastic.
Yeah, even on stage, they were fun. Like, they were making jokes with the crowd in between songs. And, like, even JB, he was up there, like, wearing flip-flops, like, just not
which
even
is
wearing.
Apparently his signature. Yeah. So that's really cool. That's really cool. Anyway, enough about the band. I thought we were going to approach the thing and just kind of enjoy the video and the music, but there was some substance in the lyrics.
Mm.
And like I said, Matt being a Christian, the lyrics could be generic, but with Matt being a Christian, I'm going to assume there's some spiritual undertones here. In fact, he signed my Constellations book, you know, his name, and he put a Bible verse in there, which I thought was a good touch. You know, it's just using his platform as an opportunity to witness, which I think is admirable.
Yeah.
Especially in such a dark environment as that. And half the people probably don't even, know a Christian. And then here he is witnessing.
Mm-hmm.
So let's look at a couple of the lyrics. It's a real stretch here. The song could be about, the first line says, "Tonight I saw a father's love and waves start to rise. I will not stand by and watch what I made be demonized." So this could be the Father God.
Mm-hmm.
Could be a generic father, maybe his son's being bullied or something like that. I'm reading it as, God's love for us. He's not going to stand by and allow us to be victimized by the devil. Does that make sense? Demonized in this, because he says, and I think the next line says, "He insists you dug a hole of bitterness."
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who the he is, but my assumption is that he is, since there's an accusation, he insists you dug a hole. This could be the accuser saying you can't get out of the situation you're in, the accuser being Satan, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So now you got this, what do you call that, duality, whatever, dualism here. You got the Father and Satan kind of, going after the same person, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
And again, the next line is why I keep thinking this may be related to Father God, because it says, "Righteous wrath wrapped in empathy." That is a perfect description of God.
Mm-hmm.
This is somebody who's rightfully angry, but he has so much empathy that he still loves us. And he uses some nice descriptive language, like a hurricane passing over a calming sea. You can see this juxtaposition, if that's the right word.
Mm-hmm.
I'm throwing out some crazy words today, of this calm sea and this hurricane, this forest fire and pouring rain.
Mm-hmm.
Really cool. When I think about God's wrath, J.I. Packer, one of the first books I read on theology, was Knowing God. And he says, "God's wrath in the Bible is never the capricious, self-indulgent, irritable, morally ignoble thing that human anger so often is. It is instead a right and necessary reaction to objective moral evil." So God is rightfully angry at sin, for example,
mm-hmm.
Because when we sin, we violate him, right?
Yeah.
Cosmic treason, as I've said on the channel, which I got from R.C. Sproul. Mm-hmm. We are the one who created us and gave us life. We are hurting him.
Yeah.
We're violating his character. We're ignoring his existence, so to speak.
Yeah, essentially.
But interestingly, now people hear, I know you hear God's wrath, like, well, God's of wrath, and that's da da da. God's wrath is his love in action against sin. He has to punish sin or he'd be unjust. So he's rightfully angry when somebody takes another's life that they shouldn't. Mm-hmm. Murder, rape, adultery. Mm-hmm. You name the sin, because those kind of sins hurt you. You see those as big things. Like somebody rapes you, oh, wow, that's terrible. God needs to punish that person. That's sin. Mm-hmm. God feels that way about adultery and fornication. About
all sin.
About all things that violate his character and his purpose for us. So he's rightfully angry, but he has empathy. And I want to skip ahead a little bit because one of the last lines, he says, where is it? He says, there is no judge. I am the jury and the defendant. The gavel has no hand. Who will deliver the sentence? Hmm. Now, but God's righteous wrath is wrapped up in empathy as he provides a substitute. He's rightfully angry with us, but his empathy for us provides a substitute. The judge of the world stepped from behind the bench and became the defendant. Mm-hmm. See, I am the jury and the defendant. Romans 3:26. It was to show his righteousness at the present time so that he might be just and the justifier of the one who has faith in him. He's just because he upholds his law, but he's the one who justifies you by stepping in your place. He's mm-hmm. the justifier of the one who has faith in Jesus. Mm. And in one of the lines, he says, we need a defender who bends so we don't break. Deuteronomy 32:4. The Lord is your mighty defender, perfect and just in his ways. Your God is faithful and true. He does what is right and fair. It's right for him to be angry at sin. It's fair for him to punishment. He provided a substitute who takes that punishment, which is right and fair. Because mm-hmm. now justice is served, but on another party, which is Jesus. That's why we believe in Jesus. That's why Jesus died on the cross. He mm-hmm. lived the life we couldn't live, died the death we should have died, mm-hmm. rose on the third day, defeating death and sin. Mm-hmm. And just by trust in him, we receive his righteousness. He becomes both just and the justifier. He fulfills the law and he saves us.
Yeah.
Isn't that awesome? Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's anything to do with the song, but those are the things that came to my mind. Yeah. I may have hijacked the intention of the song, but either way, mm-hmm. either way. There was one line, I don't know what he meant. He said, I would do anything to make it through, but it takes two. One is me, the other is you. I would do anything to make it through, but it takes you. So I don't know, from a spiritual perspective, he starts off with a little bit of what's called synergism. Mm-hmm. Synergism is this idea, and again, I may be pulling this way out of context, his intention, but this is what it's making me think of. Synergism is the idea that God, that man plays a part in their salvation, and God plays a part in their salvation. Mm-hmm. So he extends a hand, and we reach out and grab it, and then we're saved. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. the problem is, so the analogy people use a lot is like a drowning man. You know, somebody reaches out to save him, you reach out to be pulled out of the water. The reality mm-hmm. is the Bible says we're dead in our trespasses and sins. We're dead at the bottom of the ocean.
Dead.
Yes. Mm-hmm. The rescuer dives in, rescues our dead body, and resuscitates us to newness of life. Mm-hmm. That's monergism. God's mm-hmm. solely responsible for our salvation.
Just God.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So he starts off synergistic, but then he says, one is me, the other is you, so there's synergism. Mm-hmm. And then he said, I would do anything to make it through, but it takes you. Really, mm-hmm. God's the only one that has the power. Mm. Salvifically speaking, anyway.
Yeah, but it takes you.
Mm-hmm. But it takes you. So, all in all, really good song. Video was great, man. That breakdown was sick. I was sick. I kept seeing on Instagram people like, that breakdown was sick, and they weren't lying.
It's like
I almost fell out of my chair. See, you can say it because you're young and hip. When I say it, it sounds goofy. Mm. Anyway. Well, that wraps up another video. Hopefully that was helpful to you and hopefully you had some fun. If so, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and shoot me a message if you have any questions. I can be reached via email at rob@pastorrobberyacts.com or via social media DM. That's probably the best place to reach me. I'll do my best to answer you or send you some resources that can help. Thank you again for watching. We love you all. Until next time, may the light of the Lord continue to shine on you. We'll see you on the next video.
Peace.
Peace.